when you go overboard, the chances of survival are very slim. So I knew. I didn't want to admit it, but I knew then. I met Troy 25 years ago in Prince Rupert. We liked to travel lots. We were spontaneous, and he understood me, and he was always very gentle and very kind. Life was just perfect the way it was. He didn't aspire to be a tugboat operator. He wanted to provide for the family, and at the time, that was one of the only opportunities that he had. You know, when you and I are sleeping at 3:30 in the morning, the ship's coming in and these tugboaters are out pushing and pulling big container ships in and out of port. He was a part of a company, Wainwright Marine. He was always away from home. He never had any downtime. He would literally get in the door, sit down, 2 seconds later, get a text, "Oh, you're leaving in 24 hours. They started putting pressure on him, and all of a sudden he's having anxiety attacks. It should be up to the employer to deal with the strains of workers that are tired and that need to take some time. There's also regulations that manage that as well, and were they being followed? No. At about 6:45, he was up cooking breakfast for my son, and he gave me a hug, and then I drove away, and that's the last time I seen him. He had phoned me a few times before as they were loading the boat. I said to him, you know, "What's the weather?" And he said, "It's not looking good." And then another guy went down the dock. He said to Troy, "I've been doing this for many, many years. Do not go out in that weather." And Troy said, "I'm not gonna go. You're right." There was two phone calls that were made. He called the office, that was confirmed. And then he got another phone call 10 minutes later from a manager at the company. And not too long after that, Troy was gone. The weather was probably the worst weather you could get in one of the most treacherous canals in the world. They may have called a mayday and may have tried to turn around and were struck by the barge from behind and taken down. Coming from a wife of a deceased mariner, that there's not a lot of clout there. So I needed someone to be able to take what our concerns are and their concerns and to work together collectively. The union, the ILWU, has come in as kind of a family that we never thought that we had. So we need to work to really put it out there. There needs to be more awareness and protection around those workers because they seem to be just left out at sea.
I'm convinced that Troy wouldn't have died if he was listened to by his company. If the company did not send him out with those weather conditions and with untrained people on board. There has to be some change in this sector. It's a company's responsibility to follow all the legislations, but it's port authorities and governments to make sure that those legislations are being followed. At the moment, conditions are only getting worse. The race to the bottom in this industry. This is going on now for years already, and the tug industry is really necessary because without tugs, the world trade will stop. And that's why ITF and ETF together want to negotiate with those big shipping companies. We have all the same problems worldwide. Bad training, bad working conditions, no overtime payments, a lack of maintenance, a lack of safety drills, resting hours not being respected. This is why those accidents happened. And that's why ITF is so important, because they are representing so many tugboat workers worldwide. With all the different unions worldwide, we are really a close family now. We call upon governments, on port authorities, and certainly on the shipping companies to talk with us, because the working conditions of our people, that's the most important thing that we will fight for. These giants are demanding unsustainable rates for the tugboat services with no regards for the consequences. So we will continue our fight to make sure no more employees ever have to die. We will not stop until every tugboat worker has a safe working place.
I've been told as a widow to let it go, walk away, don't deal with it, just let him rest. But if I and other people allow for the injustices to happen, nothing's going to get changed, and we will continue to lose lives to these injustices.